In the name of God. The title of our paper is Proposing a Novel Method for Fake News Detection Based on Propagation Tree. Nowadays, online social media platforms are playing an important role in news broadcasting due to their convenience, speed, and accessibility. Social media platforms may quickly produce massive amounts of misleading information, altering public opinion, and allowing malicious groups to manipulate public events like elections. There is overlap between the definition of fake news and the definitions of other concepts, such as rumor and disinformation. So far, no comprehensive definition of fake news has been developed, and similar to the previous work, we define fake news as low-quality news articles with intentionally false information. Fake news detection approach can be divided into four categories, including content-based models, user-based models, propagation-based models, and hybrid models. Content-based models use the content of a news article, including the title and the body of news, in addition to the images and videos that have been used in the news articles to analyze the veracity of a news article. User-based models use the features related to profile of users who are involved in sharing the news to analyze the veracity of a news article. Also, propagation-based models uses the information related to the spreading process of a news article to predict its veracity. And also, hybrid models use the benefits of the three models simultaneously to predict the veracity of a news article. In this section, we offer a new methodology for detecting fake news that is based on studying the propagation theory over time. Previous work have investigated the propagation theory statically and ignore its development process. In the proposed model, we dynamically investigate the propagation theory and analyze its development process over time. To this aim, we continuously extract related features from the constructed propagation trees and utilize a kind of recurrent neural network to capture the temporal dynamics of extracted features and identify the development model of the propagation theory over time in order to estimate the validity of a news article. At the first step of the proposed method, we construct the propagation tree. As depicted in this figure, a propagation theory is developed to investigate the process of a news dissemination. We have utilized Network X library in Python to construct the propagation tree. The propagation tree is made up of four nodes, including news article, tweet, retweet, and reply. The propagation theory root is a news article, and the related tweets are directly connected to the root. Every tweet may be a subtree with multiple retweets and replies nodes. On Twitter, a user may respond to an initial tweet or another user's reply. When users respond to each other, a conversation thread is created, which is represented in the propagation theory as the chain of replies. The propagation trees for each news article are constructed, and the related features are extracted in time frames with a defined length in order to capture the development process over a certain period of time. We measure F1 as the total number of notes, F2 as the total number of tweets, F3 as the total number of retweets, and F4 as the total number of replies existing in the propagation tree for each time. In order to determine how far the users have disseminated the news, we measure F5, the depth of the propagation tree at the end of each time. This feature measures the distance of the farthest node to the root. In each time frame, the average time difference between generating two successive nodes, including tweet, retweet, and reply in the propagation theory, is computed as feature F6. The feature F7 is the number of not verified users who shared the news article. The users who are involved in sharing the news article will be divided into the leader and normal categories. The ratio of the number of followers to the number of following for the leader users is greater than 1, and also the number of followers for leader users is greater than 1,000. We use the number of leader users as F8 and the number of normal users as F9. who involved in sharing the news as two features. We measure the out degree of tweets to identify the influence of tweets in the propagation theory and use the maximum tweet out degree as feature F10. In addition, to identify the tweets having the least impact on the propagation theory, we count the number of tweets that don't have an out degree as feature F11. We evaluate the time interval between the initial tweet and the final retweet or reply to determine the life cycle of the news article as F12. To determine how quickly a news tweet gets retweeted, the average time difference between the tweet's posting time and the time of the first retweet is computed for all tweets in the propagation tree as feature F13. Also, we calculate the time difference between the initial tweet and the tweet with the maximum out degree to determine how much time it takes for the user with the most impact on the propagation theory to publish the news as feature F14. 2. Identify the development model of the propagation theory. We utilize two parameters, alpha and beta. Parameter alpha determines the number of propagation theories that are generated for each news, and parameter beta defines the time interval between two sequences of generated propagation theories in hours. This figure represents the development process related to the propagation theory of a fake news article, assuming the parameters alpha and beta are 4 and 24 respectively. To capture the development model of constructed propagation theories, we use a kind of recurrent network, namely LSTM, to achieve memory and retrieve information ever seen. In theory, it seems that classical recurrent networks can record and use the information in a long sequence, but they are limited in practice and only record the information from a few previous steps. Traditional recurrent neural networks suffer from the well-known vanishing gradient issue, which limits the model's ability to learn long-term dependencies. The LSTM network addresses this issue by keeping relevant information in memory cells and removing unnecessary information, and it outperforms traditional recurrent neural networks in general. The capacity of the LSTM network to learn long-term dependency among data sequences is its most obvious capability. As depicted in this figure, the LSTM network is composed of many cells, and each LSTM cell consists of a memory cell running through the whole network and three principal gates: forget gate, input gate, and output gate. After constructing alpha propagation trees over time, the related features are extracted from each propagation tree, and later the resultant vectors are fed into the LSTM network cells. And finally, the output hidden state of the last LSTM cell, which represents the development process of the propagation theory over time, will be sent to a fully connected neural network, as depicted in this figure. The output of the fully connected network will be a number between 0 and 1. If the value of the resultant number be greater than 1, than 0.5, the news article will be protected as fake, and otherwise the news article will be considered as real. The parameters of model are learned using the binary cross entropy loss function as the following form. To evaluate the proposed model, we have used fake news net repository. The fake news net repository comprises two well-known datasets, including PolitiFact and Gossip Girl. The statistical information of these two datasets is provided in this table. After investigating the extracted features, we observe that features F6, F12 and F14 have more discriminative value and get statistically significant differences between fake and real news on both datasets, according to the statistical t-test. These box plots illustrate the differences in the distribution of features F6, F12 and F14. After investigating these features, we observed that the average time difference between the two consecutive notes in the propagation theory of fake news is lower than real news. This demonstrates that fake news may spread more quickly than real news. The average time difference between the first tweet and the last retweet or reply in the propagation theory of fake news is smaller than real news. This shows that the life cycle of fake news is shorter than real news. The average time difference between the first tweet and the tweet with the maximum of degree related to the propagation theory of fake news is smaller than real news. Also, as depicted in these figures, we compute the Pearson correlation coefficient among the extracted features on the PolitiFact and Gossip Cup datasets. We observe that features F6, F12, and F14, which obtain statistically significant differences between fake and real news, have lower Pearson correlation coefficient with other features on both datasets. We use different values for the alpha and beta parameters to evaluate the proposed model. The proposed model's outcome for different values of alpha and beta parameters, as depicted in this slide, are compared to the state-of-the-art baselines, including HPFN and UPF. The results show that the most accuracy and F1 measures of the proposed model on the PolitiFact dataset are achieved by setting parameters alpha to 6 and beta to 2. The proposed model outperforms state-of-the-art baselines in the accuracy and F1 measures by 2.3% and 3.1% respectively. Also, the results on the Gossip Cup dataset show that the proposed model's most accuracy and F1 measures are achieved by setting parameters alpha to 12 and beta to 2. The proposed model outperformed state-of-the-art baselines by 1.2% and 0.9% on accuracy and F1 measures respectively. Also, as depicted in this table, we provide the titles of fake news articles for the PolitiFact dataset that traces the slightest average time difference between two consecutive notes, the most time difference between the first tweet and the last retweet or reply, and the least time difference between the first tweet and the tweet with the maximum of degree. And finally, as the conclusion, the purpose of this work was to investigate the possibility of detecting fake news using the features related to the propagation theory. In this work, we provided a new method for continuously constructing and analyzing the propagation theory related to the news articles. Also, we extracted novel features related to the propagation theory of news articles and used LSTM network to capture the development model of constructed propagation theories over time. The results indicate that the proposed method may enhance the accuracy of the state-of-the-art baselines methods for detecting fake news. Early fake news detection is the merit of the proposed method. Thank you for your attention.